Hello everyone, welcome back to our series of Core Java, and in our lesson number 7 we are going to learn about for loop. In our last session we have seen how we can use while loop in our program, in our code, and similar to that for loop also functions in the same way. But the difference is that in for loop we get much more flexibility with our coding. To understand this better, let's go to our Eclipse. Okay. Here I have already declared an array of int data type. The name of this array we will say values. Okay, so how we can print this? The primitive way, or to say the basic way, is to printing it like this, right? Like index wise, let's say 0, let's say 1, 2, 3, whatever. So in that manner we know we can print the value of this array in that index. For example, values 0, we get the value at 0 index. But using for loop we can do the same thing with a single line of code. That means the same line of code, this line of code will be run again and again till the condition is satisfied inside the for loop. So let's say I write for, I declare one variable inside this, I equals to, let's say 0, and the condition will be I less than values dot length, and with each loop what it will do, it will increment the value of I. Okay, so this is our for loop. In for loop, using the semicolon we can divide the block, or you can divide the code. Like first we can declare one variable, then we can declare the condition, that means till when the for loop will run, and then we can set a condition for the increment of the value inside the for loop. Okay, so in this case this means that we have initialized the value of I to 0, and the for loop will run till the condition that I is less than the value of values dot length. Okay, that means till 0, and the length will be obviously 10, and it will run till the value of I is 9, that means less than values dot length, so less than 10. Till the condition of less than 10 is satisfied, the for loop will keep on running, and with each iteration of the for loop the value of I will be incremented by 1. Okay, now let's write a block of code, let's write some code inside this. For example, we want to print the values at index I is values. Simply we'll put the index as I. So here this println will print the value of I also, and the value of the array at index I. Okay, now we will run this code. So you can see that at each index the value of the array is being printed by this for loop, by this for loop. Okay, so this is how we can do this. This is how we can use the for loop. So coming to our next subtopic, for each loop. So this is a type of for loop that is supported in Java. Okay, so similar to this code, the for each loop will function the same way this for loop will function. Okay, but the coding will be much simpler. Let's say I write int value for values. So this is the syntax of for each loop. That means for each value inside this values array, this for loop will keep on running. Okay, so the array values, inside this array values, whatever the integer value that it has, that will get in this for each loop. Similarly, we can write code like, I can simply copy this, the value is, let's say, well, okay. Also, we'll comment this out. Now when I run this, see, this is how easy it is. Simply, the for each loop will print the values inside the array, and this is the output that we will be getting. Okay. Hope you understood the concept of basic for loop and for each loop. For your better understanding, I will show you another example how for loop can be used. So we'll go back to the previous for loop. Here, see, it may seem basic, like we are only limited to this, but it is not the fact. For example, I equal to 0, then we can also declare b equals to 10, for example. And I'll change the condition also, like I less than b, okay, and I increment, and b will be decrement. Then here I can print like a equals to a, and similarly I can print, oh sorry, it's I actually, okay, then b equals to b. Okay, so if I run this, see, it run till the initial value is I equal to 0, b equal to 10. It run that, then as you see, we have incremented the value of I and decremented the value of b. So likewise, in the next iteration, we can see I equal to 1, b equal to 9. So like that, till this condition of I less than b is satisfied, it will keep on running. Okay, so this is the use of comma inside the for loop. Okay, that means we can initialize multiple variable inside the for loop, and we can also make it like so, like that means we can increment or decrement multiple variable, or even put other conditions also. So I hope the concept of for loop and for each loop and different uses of for loop is very much clear to you now. And if you have any other doubt, then feel free to comment below and we'll make sure to reply and clear your doubts. Make sure to like and share the video and the Core Java course with any of your friends, whoever is interested in Core Java, and tune in for the next lesson. Thank you.